Again, thank you so much for joining us here on Idaho Today, opening with Macbeth in 2014 and becoming a nonprofit in 2018. The Boise Bar Players are committed to making Shakespeare and other classics affordable and accessible to the Treasure Valley. So we have the Boise Bar Players here with us in studio to share more. So great to have you. Introduce yourselves, please.
Awesome. Hi, I'm Tiffany Eller, and I'm the managing director of the Boise Bar Players.
Wonderful.
And I'm Chris Canfield, and I'm the artistic director of the Boise Bar Players.
Great to have you
and
both here.
Macbeth actor.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. Excellent. Wonderful. And what role do you play?
Macbeth.
You play Macbeth?
Yes, I've been.
Fantastic.
Can I say that in the studio? I don't know.
You know. I know. That's why I was so shocked that you said that you opened in 2014 with it. Okay, so we got to loop everybody in here.
Right.
So if you're not a thespian, saying Macbeth is supposed to be bad luck in the theater, right? Like,
yeah.
It's the show in which you do not name.
So we say the
yes.
Scottish play is typically
the Scottish
how it's
play.
To.
That's yeah. right. Yes. All right. So hopefully no lights come falling on anyone's yeah. head or anything. All right. So tell us about the Boise Bar Players.
Well, it originally started. The Boise Bar Players is a small mobile Shakespeare and other classics theater company that started in 2014 as a way for myself and some other Boise State theater grads to have a project to do. But then it got so much attention in the kind of the stripped down minimalist version of that we did. Got enough attention that we got asked, are you going to do another one? And I said,
wonderful.
Well, no, that would be fun. So then it became a thing. And so becoming a nonprofit in 2018 and now coming around to the 10-year anniversary doing Macbeth for the second time.
Wonderful.
And
that is super awesome.
And our mission is to make Shakespeare affordable and relatable to everyone in the Treasure Valley, because a lot of people aren't able to attend the theater around here because the ticket prices are so high. So mm-hmm. our goal is to keep our ticket prices at $20 or less uh-huh. to hopefully make that more accessible to more people here.
I love that, because also you're giving an opportunity for other, you know, for all individuals to fall in love with the theater and be
exactly.
exposed to something. Because I think also too, when it comes to Shakespeare, there is a little bit of a stereotype, right? You're laughing because you're like, yes, I know. And they're, oh, I don't understand it. Or it's like, no, actually you will.
Right.
And it is so entertaining and
right.
beautiful. I mean,
right.
there's just so many. I mean,
right.
I love Shakespeare myself.
Oh,
so
good.
I'm already drinking that Kool-Aid.
Yes.
But I think it's a brilliant idea to make this something that everyone will have an opportunity to see and be a part of.
Yeah.
So let's talk about your upcoming shows that you guys have.
Yeah, so right now we're smack dab in the middle of the run of Macbeth. We've got 4 more performances starting tomorrow through the end of the weekend, so Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, of Macbeth at Searle's Place in Garden City.
Okay.
Friday's already sold out.
So
wonderful. Thursday, Friday, and Sunday, or Thursday, Saturday, and Sunday, excuse me. And then this upcoming summer, we have Cymbeline, which hasn't been done in Boise since the 90s, I think.
Mm, nice.
A lesser known Shakespeare, which we're taking a risk, but it's going to be a wacky, fun, over the top, ridiculous show. And I encourage everybody to come out and see us. And that one will tour across the Treasure Valley area. Our summer production, we always put in different places. So the Bishop's House next to the Old Penn,
ooh,
Hilltop
lovely.
Station up on Highway 21.
Nice.
Carl Miller Park and Mountain Home, which we've had a deal with for the past 5 years. So this one will travel all across the area.
And while you guys are a traveling Shakespearean production, is your approach to set and costume, is it a little more tailored down?
Yes,
okay.
Actually, it's a good way to put it, tailored down. Minimalist is kind of the idea,
yeah.
the word I cling to, and most of our productions, stylistically anyway, we tell actors, bring what's in your closet.
Yeah.
Because we have to be able to relate to people in today's day and age.
Yeah.
So a king may be wearing a blazer as opposed to, you know, sash of office.
Oh, nice. Okay,
yeah.
I like that. Okay, so you're also kind of giving a little modern twist, if you
right.
will,
yeah.
to help bridge that relatability.
Right, exactly.
And so with stripping down of the costumes, it makes the words really stand out. And so
yeah.
what I like to say is our actors understand the words so well that you don't have to understand every word to understand and enjoy the play.
Right.
There you go. So well said. Perfect. So a little bit of Grotowski, if you will, approach. A little approach to the poor theater on that, right? Where you're making it more about the performance itself, opposed to the aesthetic.
The bells and
right.
whistles.
The bells
yeah.
and whistles.
Yes.
I love it. Where do people go to learn more?
They can go to boisebardplayers.org, and you'll find tickets to Macbeth and info about our entire season there.
Wonderful. And do you guys do casting calls too, by the way?
We do. Our auditions are usually in the winter.
Okay.
So around January, or look for notices for auditions somewhere in the November, December area.
Wonderful.
And we strictly hire local, so.
Love. All right, everyone. We'll be right back. We'll be right back.